Well, I am visiting with a new company, Gardening Like a Girl. I'm with Mary and Tom, and they are at Subaru Garden Dayz today. And Mary, you guys are really looking at doing a prototype of something near and dear to our heart, garden gloves.
Yes, we are. We are working very diligently and have been for some months now to create a new women's gardening glove. The company started because I got really frustrated in the yard, primarily because if we look at the glove you have on, according to our survey, this is like the women's gardening glove of choice at this point. The problem I was having was here with the fingertips wearing out. Also that, you know, as you can see on this one, the nitrile would come off. And with the open weave on the back, the dirt would come in through the, not only through the fingertip where the hole was, but also through the cuff.
Right.
And so, you know, there's nothing worse than working in the garden and having, you know, fingernails full of dirt and splinters in your hands.
Right.
As we started to do the research, on the gloves, we discovered that this material is like a rubberish coating, is actually called nitrile, and nitrile contains two copolymers, one of which is on Prop 65's known carcinogen list. It's also on the American Cancer Society's known carcinogen list. So as a cancer survivor, I really wasn't interested in wearing gloves that had known carcinogens in them. So, you know, that's where we started, and it's been a fun journey so far.
I bet. And so Tom over here has lots of background in gloves. So where are you at with that?
Well, basically what we set out to do is we wanted to make sure that we had a glove that was very, very durable. We also wanted it to protect. Of course, the glove is supposed to protect, but we wanted to protect from the debris, sawdust, bark dust, all that type of stuff that gets in your glove. And then we also wanted it to fit. So what we did is basically we created a wrap-over tip, and this is made from a very durable material. So the durable tip basically protects from holes, but also protects the fingernails. So you won't end up with a trash fingernails. The other thing we did is we focused on natural material, so it's natural goat skin, and then we also want to use recycled material, so that both the mesh and also the elastic comes from recycled materials. You'll notice we worked the cantor ribbon actually into our design as well. Mary's going to talk a little bit more about that. But the key for us, obviously, is fit as well. And so that's what we're going to really be focusing on, and hopefully get some help on that today.
Really, because fit is the whole thing. I mean, we're going to be in our garden, we're working, and we want to be able to have that glove on and help us do those chores.
Well, a glove is supposed to fit like a glove. And what we heard from a lot of the women when we did the research is the fingers, when they don't fit, they'll actually flop over.
Mm.
And so they're too wide, the finger stalls are too wide, they flop over. So you end up just taking them off. And so that really defeats the purpose.
Definitely, definitely. And Mary, you're working on more than just gloves. You have a product line of clothing.
We do. We have the softest t-shirt you'll ever wear.
It is soft.
It is soft. And so it comes in different colors, different styles, short sleeve, long sleeve. The materials it's made from is 25% beech trees, 25% organic cotton, and 50% recycled plastic bottles.
Wow.
So super cool. And we have our Sun Garden Girl on the back. These have been really popular. And then also our hang tag is made from seed paper. You plant this in your garden, cover it with about 1/8 of an inch of dirt, water, and love, and it will grow non-invasive wildflowers. So yes, we really love our apparel. I wear it all the time.
Mary, these shirts really do feel good, but there's a feel-good story about the manufacturing of the shirts, too.
You know, there is. The shirts are made from materials from the United States, and they are cut and sewn in Haiti.
Wow.
And the story behind Haiti is that young adults come out of a global orphanage organization, and they are taught how to sew t-shirts.
Wow.
Which, you know, is a great life skill for them to have. It's a great trade for them to learn, to be able to live, in their culture
and do excellent.
Yes.
And then you also give back from your company, too. What's that?
Yes, you do. You know, Tom, we do. Tom and I are both cancer survivors. We donate 10% of net profits to the American Cancer Society. At this point, that's who we're donating to. We've been able to write 3 checks.
Wow.
You know, and we're really happy to be able to do that. It means a lot to us.
That is wonderful. Mm-hmm. So today we're at Subaru Garden Dayz. And so, Tom, how can we help when we come see you at the event?
The biggest help that you can actually do for us today would be to come on out and help us with that final fit and wear test. Wear test obviously is critical for us. We want to make sure our product fits and feels great. So if you can come on out and help us with that, that'd be awesome. Also, you can like us on Facebook, we're on Twitter, we're also on LinkedIn, and then coming up in the next week or so, we'll actually be launching our Kickstarter program. So you can help us on Kickstarter as well. So please come on out, check us out, and we'll be very happy for your help.
So, you know, go to GardenTime.tv. We'll click you over to see their Facebook page, and then you can get more information when you come and see them at Subaru Garden Dayz today. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.